Hi folks, René Modenaar here for GNS Threefold. Let's have a look at the BGP attribute weight. So what do we have? Four routers, different autonomous systems, and we have to set up some BGP so we can play with the weight attribute. So first of all, I'm going to set up IBGP and EBGP between all of those routers. And I'm going to make sure that we advertise the physical interfaces and the loopback 0 and 1 interfaces in BGP. So let's get started with that. Normally I would use the loopback interfaces for internal BGP. But because there are only two routers, I'm not going to do this. And we'll just use the physical interfaces here. And there we go. So each router has a loopback. Loopback 1 and loopback 0. So let's type in some network commands here. I'm just going to advertise everything in BGP. It's a lot of typing, but it's for a good cause. Here we go. So that should be everything. And there's plenty of stuff here in the BGP table. And I think everything should be reachable. So we'll just continue with the next tasks that we have. We're going to use the weight attribute. And first we'll start with router Stevens. Traffic to this network should be sent to router Warren. And let's see what we have over here. Show IP BGP. So if you look at this network, you can see that this is the next hop that we are using. And now I want to make sure we use this one. And we can use weight for this. So I'm going to use a route map. Weight is the higher the better. So I'm just going to create a route map that will match this single network. Let's do a clear IP BGP and let the magic happen. Here we go. You can see that the weight is now 500, and this is the I'm making a very stupid mistake here. That's the wrong neighbor I'm applying this route map to. Of course, that should be router Warren. So let's see what happens now. Here we go. This is what I was looking for. You can now see that we are using this address for the next hop, which is router Warren, however you pronounce it. And that's because the weight is 500, which is better than zero. Good, so that's the first one. Let's do the next one. Configure router Stevens to ensure traffic to 44. Keeps the same next hop, even when someone would change another BGP attribute like local preference or origin. Okay, so the whole list of BGP attributes, weight is the first one. So if you change the weight, then local preference or origin or MAT or AS path or anything else won't influence it anymore. So let's look at router Stevens again. And let's look at this network. 44 is right here. There we go, 44. So what I'm going to do is this weight over here, 32,768, that's the highest weight that you can have. So we'll create an access list that matches this network. And we'll set the weight to 32. Okay, that's a mistake I'm making. That's not the highest value. It's just the default value. The highest is 65,535. So let's change it to that. That's all good. And let's apply it. So let me take a look at my route map here. Don't forget to add an empty statement, otherwise everything is denied. So that looks good to me. And the access list looks good as well. Clear IP BGP. And you can see that a change has been made. And this is a funny example, so I took the wrong router because now the weight has been changed to 24.4. But okay, so that's a mistake I'm making, but actually this is a good example. So the next hop used to be 13.3, and that's what I want it to be. So what we are going to do is create another route map. Let's call it Rutledge. Permit 10, match IP address 2. Set weight at 65,000 something. Router BGP. 12 neighbor don't forget the empty statement Okay, so right now the weight is the same for both paths. And I'm going to change the other route map. So I want this next hop over here to be the one that I'm using and not this one. So let's take a look at route map weight. Do it like this. So what I'm doing, if I look at the picture on router Stevens, if you learn about network, what was it, 44 from router Rutledge, it should set the way to 65,000 something. If you learn from this net about this network from router Warren, then it should have a much lower weight, and this will ensure that it will always take the path through router Rutledge. There we go. So here you see the difference in weight. And if the weight is this high, weight is the first attribute in the BGP attribute list, it will ensure that local preference, MAT, AS path or anything else doesn't matter anymore. Okay, so that's how you can do it. Let's continue. Router Rutledge, traffic to 2220, send it to router Goodwin. So right now it's going to router Stevens. Let's change the weight here. And just for fun, let's use a prefix list instead of an access list. And we'll set the weight to something high. I have to give the prefix list a name. Let's call it René. There we go. So if it matches prefix list René, we should set the weight to this value. Permit. There we go. And this should do the job. And you can see it right here. So now the weight is different, it's higher. So we're using router Goodwin to reach this network. Excellent. One more, configure Goodwin. So traffic to 11.11.11 is sent to router Rutledge. So you can see this is currently the next hop, and we are going to change it create a route map called heavy permit 10 match, and let's use another prefix list. There we go. Roadmap heavy inbound. Clear it. And you can see that we are now using this next hop address because of the higher weight. And that's the last task that we had. Okay, so that's it. That's all I have for you about the BGP attribute weight. If you enjoyed this, make sure you also check the local preference lab, ASPath, MAT, and the origin code lab. And you'll learn plenty about all the different BGP attributes. For now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.